Welcome back to Snailiad. The only reason I'm still playing on Newgrounds, by the way, is because I already started playing this at the Let's Play, and I didn't want to interrupt it. Turns out the Congregate version has achievements and stuff, and I'd really prefer to play that. Also, somebody told me that the M key is for map. Where am I on the map? I assume I am that dot in the middle of that green section, but it really could be a better indicator. Okay, I am not that. Oh, if you see the blinkiness around that S, that is the you are here indicator, and it is not very helpful at all. But it looks like we are in the worst possible place to be, because there's nothing secret around, by all appearances. Anyway, I've been asked a few times whether I prefer Newgrounds or Congregate. For historical reasons, I definitely prefer Newgrounds, and there's some things about their interface I really like. It makes it really easy to pick out a really recent good game with the way they highlight and showcase their new games. But the real censure is both the social aspect and the achievements stuff, whatever you want to call that, the metagame stuff. Newgrounds actually has a really great community, and for actually developing games, they're pretty much unbeatable for a community for that. They're awesome. And especially with how they handle music and stuff like that, it's a really great site for any flash work you could be doing. But the achievement system for Newgrounds is pretty much meaningless. It's a lot like Steam's achievement system, where achievements are only for your one game, and they don't, you know, there's no running total or anything like that, so once you've forgotten about a game, those achievements are, for all intents and purposes, gone. You know, unless you remember, oh, I got medal for punching a clown in the face 8 times, yeah. And once again, I can't find myself on the map. That indicator really could use some work. But yeah, what was I saying? The whole thing about the metagaming, the achievements, crap like that, you know, it's really a whole big Skinner box type thing. But, you know, people like that. It's like Farmville, that's pretty much the perfect example of that sort of stuff. You know, as much as you hate it, you have to admit it's a very effective way to keep people coming back. And this is, by the way, an area I could have accessed a long time ago, but I didn't think to. But with achievements, if there's really no running total, the achievements are nearly meaningless. Because, you know, there's nothing to show off, there's no total tally. And, you know, unless you really, really care about a specific game, the achievements individually in that game don't matter that much. But when they show up as part of this big number, and you're making numbers go up, people love making numbers go up. Even if people don't realize that they're just making numbers go up, people eat that crap up. They think it is delicious. And it is delicious. Your brain likes achieving stupid stuff. That's why lots of sites have the social proof sort of thing, where you can vote up other people's answers. And it's fairly similar to that concept, where, you know, oh, you can show off your, you know, whatever, coolness points. Show off your EP. With this snail shield, you won't take 80 damage when you hide in your shell. There's a reason to hide in my shell now, which is good, because I forgot how to do that. I guess you... No, I lost it. I did it once. Oh, you hold down while not moving. I'm sure I'll never use that. It'll probably be vital in some boss battle or some crap like that. I have no idea. Oh, by the way, I'm trying a new audio thingy-dingy, which will be more painful for me, but might sound a little better, so I thought I'd try it out. Don't expect whatever change I made. I still don't have super missiles? This is bullcrap. I thought the frickin' rainbow lasers were super missiles. The equivalent thereof. Well, that sucks. Well, I guess I'm going to the red. Okay. We're reloading from Snail Town. Why do I have a cursor? That's... Oh. I must have already been down here. Yeah. Yeah, I really don't like it when games do keyboard and cursor input unless it's, like, absolutely necessary. Like, if it's a shooter, it's understandable, but... Generally, you're just introducing awkwardness into the interface, which is never good, and at the same time, there's rarely a need for it. You know, it's rarely like, oh, I absolutely must be able to use the cursor because this one menu acts completely different from the others, which is a brilliant idea. No, just please don't do that, unless it's absolutely necessary. One theme among Flash games I've seen is, oh, I'll make a shooter where you have to use the mouse to aim. That won't give everyone arthritis at all. Oh yes, it is so pleasurable. I mean, if you're gonna, you know, I understand it gives you sort of the 360 degree shooter sort of freedom, which that is really nice, but you need a controller for that. If you do that with the mouse and keyboard, you're just making everything awkward at once. Whereas the dual stick control is the opposite of awkward at once, which is very nice. That's why it works well for shooters on console, even if you don't get the precision. For example, third-person shooters tend to do a lot better because precision isn't generally as important. Apparently it needs something to avoid or destroy these little thingy jobs. These Gordos. I'm gonna call them Gordos. And we've got some floaty blocks of steel underwater. Doesn't seem like a good idea, honestly. Arrow up! Thank you, up arrow! Aw. You lied to me, up arrow. I'm sure there's some stupid power-up I'm supposed to get. I just don't have it. Maybe I get the freeze beam, then I jump off the stupid floating little bug things like in Super Metroid that were kind of really annoying. Health, yeah! Health. Nom 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 nom. So, I have no idea what... Oh, this is the brown color door thing. I don't know what to... Yeah. That was not a Metroid door color, so I don't know what to refer to it as. I'm just gonna call it brown door color thing. No! I knew that was a bad idea. It anyway. Oh yeah. Save point. Boss time. It's one of those airlock rooms, like Metroid always has. Hey, it's bats! Oh, we'll kill your face. And the rest of you. Bat fire. Snails do not like fire. I read it in the dictionary. Or the encyclopedia or whatever the hell. I haven't read a paper encyclopedia since early high school. Since I discovered Wikipedia, and the fact that encyclopedias didn't have to be painfully awkward to use. Like, I better flip through all these pages and come around. Oh, yes. I better just have to get this other book if it's a different letter. Yes. This is an efficient way to store textual data. Yes. I want to have to pay, like, $500 for a set of them because I'm a dumbass. Yeah. So glad we don't, you know, need paper for crap like that anymore. Oh, paper. How I hate you so much. It doesn't look like there's anything up there. I think. Whoa. Suddenly different. What? What? What's going on? Okay. Calm down. Calm down. Purple door. I can... Open purple doors. Mario bricks? Hey, it's pink. It turned pink. I have no idea what's going on. I know these turtles are annoying. They don't die fast enough. Whoa. Whoa. This game is tripping me out, man. Also, jellyfish. Boss time. Oh. He looked kind of like one at first glance, though. He's a big and not an enemy I've seen before. Anyway, let's just keep wandering around until we find a boss and or another power-up. So that's pretty much all I know how slash what to do at this moment. Thank you, Up Arrow. Whoa. Secrets? Anybody? Nobody? Snails? Anybody? Oh, snail.
Oh, snail, it's you. I'm saved. Road snail took me here. It's gone, snail. It's gone bad.
Well, moon snail is going to eat our carcass or something. I don't know what this is about. I also was trying to think of a voice to do for that guy, but I panicked, so I picked Dr. Claw.
I'll get you next time, snail.
Gravity snail? Gravity snail. Whoa! What the... What? What?
Snail, you can gravity jump. Jump in the air, then hold the direction of breath jump again.
Good lord, that hurts my throat. So, that's disorienting. But fun. So... kind of awesome, but weird. Awesome. More bullets. Rapid.
Yeah.
Whoa. Spiral slurry. It's all slurious and spiralous. Sir, you're in the way. Don't look cross at me. I hate this town. This qualifies as a town, still. Also, I hope you like that shooting sound. It's never, ever going to stop. Ever. Not even in your dreams. Oh, hey. Secrets. Not secrets. Also, gravity hurts my brain. Yeah! If this was the Congregate version, we'd have a trophy now. Actually, the new grunts from the point, they have them too, but they don't really matter in the, you know, sense that they do in Congregate. I can't show off my Newgrounds trophies. I don't show off my kind of trophies, but it shows up as a big number. I understand. I love numbers. Numbers are pretty freaking awesome. Was there something up here we couldn't do because we... Oh, hey. Black door. It's a boss door. There must be a boss around here. I'm going to go find him, and I'm going to beat his face in. Is he here? No, this is just snake one. This is where I was ranting about encyclopedias. I'm not sure why. Oh, right, because they suck. That's why I was ranting. Does anyone remember Encarta? Because I should remember. Oh, that actually does bring back memories, though. Using Ask Jeeves on one of those old brightly colored iMac things that weren't called iMacs, they were called B-somethings. What were they called? Those silly Mac things, back when they called like Apple things or something. But yeah, we used Ask Jeeves because we were legit. And nobody had heard of Google yet, so we were like, oh, Ask Jeeves, it's so much better than Alta Vista. Actually, I've never used Alta Vista. I've never heard Alta Vista used as anything except, you know, saying it was something very old.
Moon snail brought me here. Isn't he nice? All the pink grass I could ever eat. Yes.
It is quite delicious, but that is coral, so not grass.
Spinning sparks. Yeah.
Oh god. It's all gravity-like. Axe. I just... Sure, I'm using the exact same power, but still, axe. Wait, so... This must be something that I can only reach because I have the gravity, right? Must be because the combat style wouldn't work otherwise. They could, just while being 100% unfair. Yeah. Most games usually tend to only be 98% unfair. And often not intentionally so. I've never had a problem with games that are hard for, like, you know, legitimate reasons, but games that are just retarded, frustrating, except actually Spacebox defeated. Oh yeah, there are medals. But see, I don't care about you. You have little points, but those points are lies. At least, best I can tell, the points don't really count up or anything. It's like the Steam achievements that are meaningless. They're lies. They're simply lies. Looks that are up. Some sort of giant. This game is looking bigger than expected. Speaking of bigger than expected, anyone still wanting me to play, what is it, an untitled story? That game turned out to be like 20 times larger than I had initially thought. So I'm gonna. That's gonna wait for a while. And it also turned out to be a hard game, apparently. After a point, so yeah. Long and difficult games are pretty much the opposite of what I normally am going to be doing here. Whoa. That's pretty sweet. Oh, I did that. Should probably watch my health. Doesn't mean I'm going to stop. Ever. That is something that, honestly, the game makes it a bit devastator. It's a, what is it? Did my shots get bigger or something? I don't get it. They look bigger. What's happening here? I don't get what the devastator is. Did it explain to me what the devastator was? I did not see an explanation of what the crap I just got. Ability. Yeah, so it's an ability, and I don't know what it is. So that's great. Let's try. I don't know what to try. I don't have anything to try. Well, I guess I'm going to watch my own video to see if there was some text I didn't read about devastation. Because there's crap that see I can't seem to do anything. Aside from God, but it's really different. So yeah. Next time in this game I figure out what I'm doing. Haha, just kidding. Maybe that does do more damage. I seem to be killing stuff better. Yeah, I'm definitely killing oh yeah, I'm killing stuff better. Did it say that I'm killing stuff better? If it did not, that is a problem, and it should be rectified. Just the same. I guess I'm just sort of rambling on continuing the game, so maybe I won't stop to do that. It's very liberating not to have to stop every 10 minutes to be like, oh god, oh my god, I'm just gonna explode. Because, you know, stupid limits, because, you know, morons. Whoa. I can change gravity in midair in any direction I want. Kind of awesome.
Hey, Snaily, if you grab the power up ahead, you want to count down from there.
Why don't you just tell me that when I pick up the power up instead of having a thing talk to me? What? When I get a power up, just tell me what it does. If you're going to have little snail people explain it to me, you have to explain it every time. You know, if I can't just pick up stuff like the Devastator and not know what the crap it does, that's not good. If it's something like a heart container, and I can immediately see that, oh, I have an extra heart, that's different. But if you're just giving me something with a vague name, no indication of what it does, you're like 50% of video games ever, but you're also being a big dumb moron. So, don't be big dumb moron. It's not worth it. Yeah, this was especially a problem in any NES games where they're like, yeah, you can read the manual, or maybe you won't even put what the item does in the manual. We'll just be like, yeah, just do stuff and see what happens. And be like, oh yeah, I picked up the green monkey butt fingers. And that gives me plus 18 to running sideways, only to the left when it's, 3 p.m. And the players will be so grateful for that, and they'll totally know what the hell is going on. Oh, there's a Helix. Wait, what? You're an enemy. You're a mutant ninja turtle. But I can't kill you. Why? This confuses me. back to the point where I have no idea what's going on. But the music is pretty awesome, so that's good. Alright, let's go. Let's go this way. We get back up. Oh, that's a gravity stuff. Okay. Let's go. The gravity thing kind of throws me off. But altering gravity does tend to do that to people. Lux Nirata. I wouldn't be able to pronounce that. This way. Okay, let's see what's down this way. Snail Town again? It's another Helix fragment thingy. Up, up, down, down, left, right, right, never mind, for some other game. Yes, yes, we all know. We all know. There's a secret down up. It's a snail! No secrets. The other snail from the house is vile to hear dirt. Isn't it nice here? I just rub myself in dirt every minute of every hour, every day. I just like to wallow in dirt. But never mind. Stop thinking about that immediately. And we're back at a point where I don't know what's going on. Well, that's a good enough time to end the video. Oh, and see, that little circle-y thing is it's a much better indicator of where you are, but when you're in a save room, you have a different indicator that's a lot harder to see. Also, about the items that I don't know what the crap they do, I still have no idea what the crap the little Helix things are. Though I think it had something to do with some sort of snail goddess. I wasn't sure what the crap the deal was with that. Isis the Snail Goddess, coming to theaters June 2011, so a few months ago.